हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर उत्सवी मोदी, सेकंड ईयर पीजी रेजिडेंट फ्रॉम डीवाई पाटिल कोल्हापुर। आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक इंडियन रेडियोलॉजिस्ट फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड आई वुड ऑल्सो लाइक टू थैंक माय गाइड डॉक्टर निरंजन सर एंड द एचओडी ऑफ आर डिपार्टमेंट डॉक्टर नितिन सर फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी। द टॉपिक फॉर माई पेपर इज Revolutioning Liver Health Assessment, a novel comparison of MR chemical shift and ultrasound elastography with CT Hounsfield unit for non-alcoholic fatty liver disease in its infancy. So the aim and the objectives of the study are to quantify the degree of fatty infiltration of the liver in patients with asymptomatic non-alcoholic fatty liver disease with MR chemical shift imaging and to compare the diagnostic accuracy of MR chemical shift imaging, USG gray scale and USG shear wave elastography with CT Hounsfield units and early assessment of hepatic steatosis and hepatic fibrosis. So the introduction, with excessive triglyceride accumulation in the liver cells can cause hepatic steatosis, ultimately progressing to chronic liver disease like non-alcoholic steatohepatitis and other complications. So roughly, if we see 15-25% non-alcoholic steatohepatitis patients may develop irreversible consequences such as hepatic fibrosis, liver cirrhosis or hepatocellular carcinoma. And unfortunately, these conditions are often asymptomatic until complications arise, earning them the label of silent liver diseases. So, the non-alcoholic fatty liver disease often goes undetected as liver biopsy, the gold standard diagnostic procedure, is typically performed only on symptomatic patients or those with elevated aminotransferase levels. However, liver biopsy has limitations, including invasiveness, discomfort, inability to determine cirrhosis severity, and sampling errors. So the non-invasive imaging modalities could serve as reliable screening tools for the non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, offering advantages such as non-invasiveness and better patient compliance, thus helping in early diagnosis of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, even in asymptomatic individuals, facilitating timely management. So the materials and methods for the study is that this is a prospective cross-sectional study was conducted in 80 patients and patients who were referred to the radiology department for abdominal imaging with the incidental finding of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease were included for the study. These patients were subjected to grayscale imaging, ultrasound point shear wave elastography, CT imaging and MR chemical shift imaging. So the introduction of the new assessment methods. The MR chemical shift imaging is a method that uses eco-time dependent phase inference, effects of fat and water to quantify the fat content of the liver by acquiring images at the eco times, at which water and fat signals are approximately in phase and opposed phase. Volumetric liver fat detection is possible based on the relative signal loss on out-of-phase images. An ultrasound elastography enables clinically non-invasive evaluation of the liver fibrosis and non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. Fibrosis is thought to function as parenchymal framework that adds rigidity. Therefore, estimation of tissue stiffness could reveal whether and how much fibrosis is present. So the point shear wave elastography staging on the liver fibrosis is as follows. Normal, then mild, mild to moderate and moderate to severe. So here we'll start with the cases. The first case, the grayscale of the ultrasound imaging, which shows a diffusely hyperechoic liver parenchyma obscuring the periportal echogenicity, but the diaphragmatic echogenicity is still appreciable. So it is the grade 2 fatty liver. So on the ultrasound point shear wave elastography for one of the samples is detected to be 8.66 plus minus 0.82. And the mean liver parenchymal attenuation for the this range of image in the right lobe of the liver and the spleen is being 30.89 HU and 52.21 HU respectively. So the MR chemical shift imaging The in phase and the out phase calculating mean is the in phase is 436.3 and the out phase is 216.8. So the fat percentage is 25.15. Case 2, the ultrasound grayscale image shows diffusely hyperechoic liver, parenchyma, the diaphragm, and the nearby structures are poorly visualized due to scattering of the incident ultrasound waves by the excess of the fat. So thus grade 3 fatty liver, and the point shear wave elastography of one of the samples is 8.11, and the CT Hounsfield units for the mean liver parenchymal attenuation, the range of image in the right lobe of the liver and the spleen is 10.65 and 49.0 respectively. And the MR chemical shift imaging, the in phase and the out phase mean, in phase is 532.3. Out phase is 57.99, so the fat percentage turns out to be 44.56 according to the formula. So the results of our study is, when the size of the liver is less than 15 centimeter, the number of patients with the size of the liver less than 15 centimeters were 22, more than 15 centimeters were 58. So the steatosis, which came to be grade 1, the 45 patients, grade 2, 27 patients, and grade 3, 27 patients, and the ultrasound, point shear wave elastography, liver fibrosis staging, normal were 14 patients, the mild were 28, mild to moderate 38, and moderate to severe was 0. So on analyzing the extent of the fibrosis in the graves of the fatty liver, it is observed that the extent of fibrosis strong correlations with the high grade of the fatty liver. And on the linear regression between the CT mean Hounsfield unit and the USG point wave shear wave elastography, it doesn't show a reliable correlation with the slope of the intercept, and thus the CT attenuation value is not reliable modality in the assessment of the hepatic fibrosis, whereas the linear regression between CT mean Hounsfield units and MRI chemical shift imaging fat estimation showed excellent correlation with the slope of the intercept. Hence, we can apply that MRI chemical shift imaging is a reliable modality for qualitative assessment of fatty liver by providing accurate percentage amount of fat in the liver parenchyma. So the discussion of the study is that the study found a strong association between fatty liver and the occurrence of fibrosis. However, it is worth noting that none of the asymptomatic patients fell into the moderate to severe fibrosis category, indicating that severe fibrosis is unlikely to develop in asymptomatic individuals. And non-enhanced CT scans were identified as a reliable modality for diagnosing fatty liver, with CT attenuation values serving as a non-invasive gold standard. And this finding has significant implications for clinical practice, as CT scans can provide accurate and accessible diagnostic information. So the linear regression analysis demonstrated good correlations between CT attenuation values and ultrasound grayscale imaging for fatty liver grading, as well as with the MRI chemical shift imaging for fat percentage analysis. These findings support reliability of both ultrasound and MRI as modalities for assessing fatty liver and quantifying fat content. In contrast to the reliable correlations found with the CT and MRI ultrasound, point shear wave elastography did not show a reliable correlation with CT attenuation values for assessing hepatic fibrosis, and this suggests that CT Hounsfield units may not be as accurate in detecting fibrosis compared to the other imaging techniques. So these are my references. Thank you.